In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can permanently add, ban or hardcode subtitles into your videos or movies. Hi, my name is David from freelancerinsights.com, where we believe you should never stop learning. If you're interested in adding subtitles to your videos where you permanently have them on at any time, or whether it's a client job that you want to do and you want to do it for free, there is a very easy application that you can use, and this application is called Handbrake. Handbrake is an application that is open source, and it's an open source video transcoder. It can convert videos from any format, and I love to use Handbrake to compress videos that are large files into small file sizes without losing quality. So basically you can use Handbrake for that, and the good thing is that it is available in multiple platforms, that is Mac, Windows, Linux, and it is free and open source. Now basically, for you to be able to achieve a video that is burnt in subtitles or hard-coded or permanently added, and for the purposes of this video, I'll use those terms, but the professional term is something we call open captioning. And if you're interested in learning how to caption videos, you can check out my course from the link below. Now, we need three things. We need Handbrake, which is the application that will help us burn in our subtitles to the video. And then we need our video and subtitle file. Now, I have my video here, which is an MP4 file on how to fix wrong subtitle numbering and timing using subtitle edit, and the caption file. I'll just double click it. It opens in Notepad and it shows you the time codes, the caption files and all that. And basically, those are the two things that we need. And the final ingredient now is our application that is already installed. So basically, for this to work, you need to install Handbrake. And I'm using the latest version, which is version 1.22. So it's opened. And basically, all I need to do for this is I just need to drag my file on here. I'll just drop it there. And it's going to scan and just post. You can check out the previews of the video, that is the screens of the video, but basically this is what we get. So I'll just maximize this. Now it shows you the source, the time, the angles, chapters, duration. Then it also gives you the presets that has been set. Now my video is in something we call 720p, so it's not a 1080p video, so I'll need to to adjust this preset. You just come and select the preset. We just want general, and let's say very fast 720p 30. So import, click on it. That's okay. And check out the summary. You see your video is still there, your subtitles are still there, and then remember to select the burn-in. Now let's come here to browse and see how we're going to save our file. We can save it with the same name, just click on it, but then we can add maybe burned subtitles and click on save, .mp4, and click on save. Now, when you're ready, just click start encoding. Depending on the strength of your laptop, your processor, your RAM and all that, and any other processes that are running inside your computer, it may take a long or short time. So I may skip a few sections here, just in case I notice that it's going to take a lot of time. Just click start encoding. Now, once you hit that, it's preparing to encode. It gives you a general and rough estimate of how long it's going to take. Basically, it's at 5, so it's going to take about 2 minutes. 2 minutes, maybe 154. And it really depends on the number of encodings that you've set. And these are set somewhere here under the video. So basically, I just set it to just do a one pass. Sometimes when I notice that when you do a two pass, it takes longer but has better quality. But there's really no big difference when you do this. But it's just for general knowledge. So I'll repeat this. If you're interested in learning how to caption videos, you can check out my course from the link below. Now, Handbrake is a tool that has been there for a long time. I've used it to burn in captions. But the only issue I have is that if you're looking to get a black background and white subtitle files or white text on screen, you won't get that with Handbrake. And I was hoping that that is something they would have added in these particular versions, so that when you add your captions or your subtitles, then you have a very good black background and the subtitle file showing, which is normally standard when you're doing open captioning, hard coding, banning in, or permanently adding subtitles to a video. It all depends on what type of name you want to call it. Now, basically, that's something I've always hoped for, and I hope that someday they do that. So we're almost done. It's saying 13 seconds remaining. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we're done. So basically, it's queue finished. I'll just go back into my folder and just double click on this video. When I double click on it, it's going to open inside VLC. Today, I'm going to show you how. Now, what I want you to see is that this subtitle file is permanently burnt into the video. Now you can fix wrong subtitle numbering and timing using subtitle edit. Hi, my name is David. Now basically, if I go into the subtitle track, there's nothing to deactivate or anything. Now, if I play this other video, since both files, the video and the subtitle file, are titled the same and they're in the same folder, if I play this video, today, if you notice, you can see the subtitle file inside VLC, but this video does not have burnt-in captions. It's just that they're in the same folder and they are titled the same way. So if I continue playing, I'm going to show you how you can fix wrong subtitle. Now, if I come and right click inside the video player and click on subtitle, you can see the subtitle track is active. And if I disable this, the subtitles disappear. So basically, what we are trying to achieve in this video, and I'm hoping that you're going to learn and achieve on your own, is that you can be able to permanently add, ban, or hard code subtitles using Handbrake into your videos or movies or whatever that you want to add to. You can make money doing this for clients, other people, and all that. And mostly where this is applicable is especially with social media videos, especially for Facebook. Most videos are played without the sound being on. And we all know that with captioning, especially closed captioning, you have to turn it on or off, the way I've shown you. So basically, if you want your viewers to enjoy your content, you should try and ensure that you hard code, ban, or add subtitles permanently. So basically, if I play this video again today, you'll see that the file going to show you is how you can open captioned.
Wrong subtitle numbering and timing.
And you cannot turn it on or off. You just see this. The only downside I have with this is that normally with this kind of captioning or banning in, you always expect to have a black background with all this. In the next tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can permanently add subtitles to your videos using Subtitle Next. These are professional captioning and subtitling software that you can apply all the different styling backgrounds to your videos. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope to see you in the next one.